Good morning. Greetings from the Holy Temple Holiness Church of Deliverance, where we are located 336 East 25th Street. But today we are online and we'd like to welcome you into our personal homes and sanctuary on today. We hope that you guys are watching and will be fulfilled with the Word of God. And we pray that God blesses you on today. Amen. We're going to start this morning off with prayer, and then we'll have a scripture from our junior missionary, Amaya Shelley. Amen. God, we just thank you for just allowing us to be online today. We thank you for just allowing us to be able to have service and to be into service. God, we thank you. We honor you. We adore you. We worship you, Lord God, and we just want to say thank you. In your mighty name of Jesus, I pray, amen.
Amen.
We will now have our scripture reading from our junior missionary, Amaya Shelley.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Today's scripture will be coming from Proverbs chapter 12, starting at the second verse. A good man obtains favor from the Lord, but a man of wicked intentions he will condemn. A man is not established by wickedness, by the root of righteous cannot be moved. That's today's scripture.
Amen. Thank you to our sister Amaya for reading this morning's scripture from Proverbs. A man cannot be obtained from wickedness, but of righteousness. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We would now like to turn this portion of the service over to our very own overseer, Margaret Shelley.
Praise the Lord. We're going to turn it into the hands of our evangelist, Belle. We are blessed, amen, to have her and my daughter, evangelist Shelley, and my granddaughter with us on today, amen, missionary Amaya Shelley. We thank God, amen, for them being here because of unforeseen circumstances. We're not able to be at the house of prayer on this morning, but we pray that you're tuning in, that you're coming on, amen, and listening to the broadcast along with us this morning. And we pray, amen, that you'll be able to get something out of the Word of God, amen, on this morning, amen, as we bring forth, amen, God's Word. Our evangelist Belle, she's going to come. Amen. And she's going to give us a song. And then, amen, she'll turn the service back over to me. Amen.
Amen. I'm going to sing a congregational song. Victory is mine. Victory is mine. Victory today is mine. You know God told Satan, get thee behind. Victory today is mine. You know victory is mine. Victory is mine. Victory today is mine. You know God told Satan, get thee behind. Victory today is mine. You know happiness is mine. Happiness is mine. Happiness today is mine. You know God told Satan, get thee behind. Happiness today is mine.
Now turning service back into the hands of our general overseer for the rest of the service.
Amen. This morning, we give honor to God. Amen. We love the Lord. Amen. And we honor him. Amen. For all of his goodness and all that God is doing for us and how God is certainly moving for us. I honor, amen, our late great chief apostle, Julia Williams. Amen. Who's absent in the body, yet present with the Lord. Amen. And we honor the late Apostle Acilia Blue. Amen. And we thank God so much. Amen. For her. Amen. Absent in body, present with the Lord. Amen. So we asking, amen. And most of all, we thank God for our living apostle, my husband. Amen. Who's not able to be with us on this morning. Amen. He has some things that he had to go take care of. Amen. At the church. Amen. And amen. Please forgive us this morning. We're trying, amen, hard, amen, to get straight, amen. With our broadcast, amen, we were planning on being in the house of prayer on this morning, amen. But because, amen, of the rain, amen, it brought water into the church, and my husband and some of the men had to go and take care of that. Amen. So we asking all of you, you and yours, amen, to bear with us on this morning. We're going to bring forth the word of God. Amen. On this morning, and we're going to be coming from Deuteronomy, the 20th chapter. Amen. And we thank God for my daughter, Evangelist Bell. Amen. We were all together on yesterday, and so the women, amen, some of us are still here at the house, and the men has went to take care of, they went to take care of what needed to be taken care of at the church. But will you pray with us this morning, and we're going to bring forth the word of God. Amen. As God has given it unto us. Amen. Amen. So she's going to start reading at the first verse.
Deuteronomy 20, start at the first verse. When thou goest out to the battle, out to battle against thine enemies, and seest horses and chariots and a people more than thou, be not afraid of them, for the Lord thy God is with thee.
Look, when you go out to battle, no matter what type of a battle it is that you're going through, you could be going through a battle on your job. You could be going through a battle in your home. You could be going through a battle anywhere. It doesn't matter where you going through a battle with. But God say, when thou goest out to battle against thy enemies and seeth horses and chariots and a people more than thou, be not afraid. Don't be afraid when you get in a battle. God will take care of you.
Amen.
God will fight for you. He said in the book of Exodus, I believe it's the 14th chapter, around about that 13th and 14th verse. He said, stand still, see the salvation of the Lord. Hold your peace and God will fight for you. God will fight your battle for you. But first of all, you can't expect God to fight your battle if you're not doing right unto God.
Amen.
There are things people, they look for God to do, and they say that God has not moved for me. God is not moving for me. Are you faithful? Are you faithful unto God in order for God to move for you? Do you pray? Do you fast? Do you seek God? But yet you want him to fight your battle and you're not doing the things that's right unto God? said, stand still and see my salvation. In other words, God wants you to seek him. Hold your peace. He's going to fight for you. God can fight for you. He'll bring you out when we do the things that's right unto God. Trust God, y'all.
Amen.
Believe God. God will make a way. God will bring you out. I don't care who your enemy is. Your enemy could be Spookama. No matter who it is, God will bring you out. He'll fight for you. Read.
Be not afraid of them, for the Lord thy God is with thee, which brought thee up out of the land of Egypt.
Look, God brought you up out of Egypt. He already brought you out before. God will do it again. But you got to seek God. You got to put it into the hands of God and let God handle it for you. Trust God. Believe God. Folks don't trust God no more like they used to. If God don't move today or tomorrow, then they don't believe that God is going to move for them. They don't believe that God is going to bring them out. Some folks, they are, when they get in trouble, then they start seeking God. They start doing everything right because now they're in trouble. But why can't we do everything right now when we can't? Because there may come a time that you might not be able to pray like you used to pray. I've been there. I went to pray and it was like I couldn't pray. But God will make intercessory for you. God will step in and he'll give you what to pray. He'll give you what to say, that self-same hour. But you got to trust God. You got to believe God. You got to know that God is God. It is God that has brought us out. It is God that has made a way for us. Trust him. Believe him. Hallelujah. Sometimes we feel that we're in a dark place and that God is not moving for us. God is moving, but he's not moving in your time. For those of you that have gotten to the point where you feel like you're ready to throw the towel in, you're ready to give up, just hold on. Help is on the way. What I mean by help is on the way, God is on the way. But you got to continue trusting God. You got to continue believing God. You got to continue knowing that God is God. Lean not to your own understanding, but lean unto God. And let God bring you out. Let God fight your battle. Hold on just a little while longer. Lord have mercy. Everything doesn't come instantly. Everything does not happen instantly. You might say, well, I've been going through on my job for months. They keep picking on me. They keep doing this. They keep doing that. And God, you haven't moved for me yet. Sometimes we got to examine ourselves. Preach. Are we more focused on what they're doing to us on this job? Or are we focused into turning it into the hands of God? Are we praying and asking God to deliver us, to bring us out, to make ways out of no ways? Lord, have mercy. Are we reading God's word? The Bible said, Ezekiel said, eat the whole roll. We got to eat the bitter along with the sweet. Sometimes we might open up the word of God And the word might say, repent. Lord, have mercy. And we don't want to hear that. We want to open up the word and we want to read where God said he'll open up the windows of heaven and he'll pour you out blessings that you wouldn't have room enough to receive. These are the things that we want to hear. We want to hear the good and we don't want to hear the bad. Lord, have mercy, but we got to be able to take the good along with the bad. Good God Almighty, we got to be able to run for our lives. Sometimes God is waiting on us. He wants to hear from us. Lord, have mercy. But we want God to do everything. And we want him to move instantly. Good God Almighty. Hallelujah. There was a widow woman who had went before the unjust judge. And the judge didn't want to deliver the woman. Lord have mercy. But the woman sought God. She sought after God. And she asked God to deliver her. I'm paraphrasing. To deliver her. Lord have mercy. And God delivered her over the unjust judge. Lord have mercy. You might have to go to court. You might have to stand before a judge. Good God Almighty. And it seemed like the judge has already favored the other people, the prosecutor, Lord have mercy, but you being the defendant, trying to defend yourself, Lord have mercy, I've learned if you take God with you, that God will bring you out, that God will move for you, that God will fight your battle. Look ahead, look ahead. There was three Hebrew boys, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Lord have mercy, because they wouldn't bow down. The King Nebuchadnezzar, Lord have mercy. Thank you, Lord Jesus, because they wouldn't bow down to the instruments. Lord, have mercy. Thank you, Lord God. King Nebuchadnezzar had put out a decree, and he had to honor his decree. Whoever didn't bow down to the music would be thrown into the fiery furnace. Good God Almighty, hallelujah, and Nebuchadnezzar, he took the Hebrew boys, and he threw them into the fiery furnace, Lord have mercy, thank you Lord Jesus, hallelujah, and when he threw them into the fiery furnace, I tell you, the Bible lets us know that the fire, it didn't even touch the Hebrew boys. It didn't touch them. Lord have mercy. And when Nebuchadnezzar, when he looked into the furnace and he saw that they were still there, hallelujah, he told his men, he said, make this fire 7 times hotter. You on that job and it seems like the boss can't get to you. The employees can't get to you.
My Lord.
So they try to make it worse for you. They want to try to make things a little worse. Hallelujah. But I come to tell you today, God don't want you to be afraid of the enemy. Hallelujah. Because God is there to fight for you.
Yes, he is.
He's there to bring you out. Nebuchadnezzar, after he made it 7 times hotter, he looked back into that furnace. And he turned around and, I'm paraphrasing again, he turned around and he looking at everybody. He said, did I not put 3 in here? I see 4. saw four, because the Son of Man had gotten into that fire along with the Hebrew boys. God will get into the fire with you. He'll go to battle for you. He'll bring you out. Excuse me. He'll make ways out of no way. But you got to trust God. You got to believe that if you're in that fire, that God is going to be there with you. Don't give up and don't give in. Hold on to what God got for you. He'll bring you out. I'm going to tell you, saints, I've been laughed at for years and years. I've been talked about. Hallelujah. I felt like I would never, never amount to anything because of the things that I had to go through. I'll never forget. This will always be a testimony. That's why I'm so thankful unto God, because if you're going through now, I can tell you that God will bring you through it. If you just hold on, if you just trust God, if you just believe God, I'm a living witness that God will bring you out. God will bring you through. God will fight your battle. It's nothing that I was just told. It's something that I went through for myself. I'll never forget. I lived in a home, and one day, this home had a mirror on the coat closet door. I mean, it was a big, thick, heavy, heavy mirror, and it was long. It was from one end of the door to the other end. And my daughter, she's sitting right here, Evangelist Bell, she was coming down the steps, and just out of nowhere, the mirror fell off the door, and it hit her in her stomach, and it cut her stomach. It was just the mercy of God that that mirror didn't go deep, deep into her stomach.
The mercy of God.
Or she wouldn't have been sitting here today. But when you praying, prayer was constantly going up in that house. Prayer. And in that same house, my daughter, my other daughter, she had her child and she came to visit us. And she was getting ready to go home, and her daughter was just a baby, maybe about 6 months old. She was just a baby. And she was downstairs in the living room, and she was putting her daughter in the stroller. And just as she was doing that, the ceiling from the house had fell and just missed her and her daughter. I guess you say, what kind of house were they living in? But God.
But God.
God took care of us.
Yes, he did.
And it seemed like the landlord didn't want to do anything to repair. So my husband and I, we had to do our own repairs, but yet still paying rent. Sometimes you got to overlook some things and do some things for yourself.
Amen.
Don't wait on man. Man will fail you. I guess you say, well, you paying rent, you shouldn't have had to do that. Yeah, we was paying rent, But when you got a slumlord and not a landlord, you have to learn to do things for yourself. And God saw my husband and I faithfulness. And now God has blessed us with our own home. Why? Because we allowed God to fight for us. We let God do this for us. God didn't have to do it. He didn't have to bring us out of that home. That was something that God wanted us to go through. You say, why would God want you to go through something like that? Why? Because the Bible says you got to suffer in order to reign.
Amen.
You want to suffer some things. Everything is not blessings. You can't look to be blessed all the time. You want to go through some things before, sometime before you receive your blessing. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So I'm trying to tell you, don't give up. We could have got angry with God and say, God got us living like this, and we serving him, we paying our tithes, we giving offerings, and we pressing our way to be in the house of prayer. God, hallelujah. We could have said, God, I can't take this no more. If I got to live like this, God, why am I living like this for you? But let me tell you something, church. I'm so glad that I did not give up on God, that I held on, that I waited for God to move. Amen. God bless us with a 5-bedroom home, 3.5 baths. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Got a kitchen, living room, dining room, a deck. God blessed us with all this. And we came from a 3-bedroom with 1 bathroom. God will bless you if you wait on him, if you trust him, if you don't give up. Lord have mercy. Don't give up on God. I don't care what you're going through. Don't give up on God. Trust God. Believe him. Read.
And it shall be when ye are come nigh unto the battle that the priest shall approach and speak unto the people.
Look. And it shall be when ye shall come nigh unto the battle that the priest shall approach and speak unto the people. Lord, have mercy. When you come nigh to the battle, God will send the priest. God sent me to speak to you today, to let you know that this battle is not yours. Yolanda Adams say it belongs to the Lord. It
belongs to God.
It don't belong to you. This is not your battle. God is allowing me to tell you today, I don't care what you're going through. If you got that husband that won't do right, you got that husband that won't live right, it ain't your battle. It's not your battle. This battle belongs to God. You put it into the hands of God. You live right. A sanctified wife make a sanctified husband. God don't want you to please that man in a way that he gonna draw you into sin. God wants you to please that man in a way that you're gonna draw him to you. You don't want to go backwards. You want to go forward. Yes, the Bible says a married woman seeks to please her husband.
Amen.
You still pleasing him when you living right, when you living holy. You cook that in spite of what he doing. If he go out and hang out all night long, you please him by still cooking his food for him. You please him by still being there for him, even though he might not be there for you the way you want him to be there for you. You keep living right.
Preach, overseer.
I've seen it done. I have a saint in my church. Her husband wasn't doing right. He wasn't living right. He was doing a little bit of everything. But she kept pressing her way to the house of prayer. She kept living right. She kept praying. She kept fasting. She kept putting him in the hands of God. And now he sits in church right next to her.
But God.
God will save and deliver. He's there for us. He'll fight the battle. I'm here to tell you today, just hold on a little while longer. Those of you that's waiting on husbands, stop looking in the world. Hallelujah. God will send you a husband. I'm sitting here a witness that God will send you a husband. Wait on him. I had to wait 6 years, but God sent him. I didn't stop praying. I didn't stop fasting, but I kept my eyes on God. Hallelujah. I continued to pray. I continued to fast. In those 6 years that it took my husband to come, I continued to pay my tithes. I continued to sacrifice. I looked at the women in the church. It looked just like the women at the church. It looked like everybody was being blessed. God was sending them husbands, everybody but me. But I waited. I waited for God. I wanted God to do this. And now I tell you, I got the best husband in the world. I thank God so much for my husband. He's a man that takes care of his wife. He takes care of his children. He takes care of his grandchildren. He makes sure that we have a roof over our head. He makes sure, amen, that through God, our needs are supplied according to God's riches. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. He used to tell me, he said, Margie, he said, one thing I'm going to do. He said, you just hang in there with me. We living in this house and a house falling apart and, you know, things just don't seem right. And he told me, he said, if you stick with me, he said, I'm going to buy you a house. And Lord knows, I'm so glad I stuck with him. And I'm so glad I stuck with God. And now I'm living in this house that he has brought me. And I thank God so much for my husband. He's a man of God. He's a praying man. He's a fasting man. He seeks after God. Amen. He don't get directions from man. He gets direction from God. And I thank God so much for that. And I come to let you know today, that's what we all us women, we need. We need a man that's going to get directions for God. You want to live right? You want to be treated right? Get a man that gets his directions from God. And vice versa. If the man is living holy and you want a holy woman, someone that's getting directions from God, you want someone that's going to please you? Get a holy woman. You have to be equally yoked. The Bible says, don't be unequally yoked with the unbelievers. Now, Apostle Paul, he gave his life to God. But when he wasn't living right, he said, he didn't say that he didn't enjoy sin. He gave up the pleasures of sin. When I was in that world, I'm not going to say that I wasn't enjoying sin, but I gave up the pleasures of sin to give my life to God because I want eternal life. I want God. I want to be able for God to receive me when I leave this earth. I want to be able to sleep with God. Hallelujah. I don't want to burn in brimstones and fire. I don't want to burn in hell. But I want to live for Christ. I want to live for God. Hallelujah. Read for us.
And shall say unto them, Hear, O Israel, ye approach this day unto battle against your enemies. Let not your hearts faint. Fear not and do not tremble, neither be ye terrified because of them.
Look here, look here. Israel, ye approach this day unto battle against your enemies. Some of you are already in a battle. Some of you are approaching your battles. Lord, have mercy. But whatever, let not your heart faint. Fear not and do not tremble, neither be ye terrified because of them. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. Don't faint. Don't fear. And do not tremble. Because God is with you. God is fighting your battle. Lord, have mercy. Sometimes that enemy will come and he'll knock you upside your head. Good God Almighty. And you don't know what done happened. Hallelujah. But hold on. Don't be afraid. Don't fear. Lord, have mercy. Don't faint. Don't faint. Press your way through this. Press your way through it. The devil is a deceiver. He'll deceive you just like he did Eve. Told Eve that she was a god. The devil tell you that you a god. That you don't have to go through this. But everything that God put us on, put on us, we have to go through it. Press your way through it. Don't faint, don't fear, don't tremble, but press your way through it. Lord have mercy. Fear comes by what you see, what you hear, and what you feel.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy. People tell you, you better fear. When this pandemic came, people heard it. They began to fear. They began to fear because of the pandemic. Lord, have mercy. Hallelujah. But we don't need to fear. God has gotten it all in control. God is taking care of us. Hallelujah. God will bring us out. Didn't he bring the children of Israel out? He sent plagues to them. He sent plagues in Egypt. He sent them there. The children of Israel hadn't came out yet. They were still there in Egypt when the plagues came. But God said, when I see the blood, I'll pass over. When God see the blood in you, then God's going to pass over.
Amen.
God's going to deliver you. God's going to bring you out. God's going to make a way for you. Hallelujah. But you got to trust God. You got to believe God. Hallelujah. You can't straddle the fence. Let me tell you this. Some folks feel that they can serve God and mammon too, but you can't. That's why God gave us a choice. He said, if it be God, let it be God. If it be man, let it be man. But you can't serve them both. You got to serve one or the other. You got to trust God, you got to believe God, or you got to trust man and believe man. But you can't serve them both. Hallelujah. Get right with God. Let God fight your battle. Let God do this for you. Hallelujah. You know, God has spoke to me that there's someone listening to this broadcast on today, and you tuned in and you're listening, and God wants to move for you. There's some things that you're doing. You're trying to serve God, and you're trying to serve man too. But you can only serve God. God will bring you out. He brought me out of so many things. I'll be here all day if I gave all my testimonies of how God brought me out. Look, the Bible say, if your brethren trespass against you 7 times 70, forgive them. No matter how much it may seem like someone has hurt you, you forgive them and let God move for you. See, it's not what they do to you that God is going to hold you accountable for. It's what you do to them. And that's what God is going to hold you accountable for. So you live right. You love. That's why we don't need to have no respect of a person. We need to love everybody. Love your enemies. Treat them right. There he calls a fire upon their own head. You love. A man told me when I was a little girl, I was probably about 7, 8, 9 years old. And he told me, he said, love the devil out of them. Sometimes you can love the devil out of people. People don't like you, but you love them. You love them anyhow. And after a while, they're going to start loving you because they don't understand why they're doing this and that and the other to you and you still love them. But when you try to do tit for tat, then you're only putting yourself in trouble with God. They took my bookmarker, so I'm going to take theirs. You can't do that. The Bible say don't render evil for evil. Don't do that. But if they take your bookmarker, you say, God, you saw when they took it. Lord, only you can fix it for me. And guess what? God will turn around and he'll bless you with another one. He'll give you another bookmark. You have two then. He'll double it. Didn't he do it for Job? He blessed Job back double.
Double.
You go through. You seek God. Job lost everything he had. He lost his children. His wife told him to curse God and die. Job told his wife, he said, you talk like a foolish woman. Sometimes people tell you stuff, you got to let them know they're being foolish. That's not God's way. His friends thought he had sinned because of all that he had to go through. He got all these balls on his body. Lord have mercy. Sometimes God may bring afflictions upon you. And because you're serving God, it seems like there is no healing. There's no healing for you. You got this affliction. But God is taking you through it to bring you out of it. Sometimes we as leaders, we got to go through some things. How can I tell you that God is a healer if God never healed me? How can I tell you that God will put monies in your pocket if he never put no money in my pocket? How can I tell you that God is a way maker if he never made the way for me? We need God to make the way for us. But I can't tell you that he's a way maker if he never brought me out of nothing. Look, before I got saved, I used to be a fornicator. I used to smoke reefer. I was in a world of sin, and I did different things before I came to Christ. But God delivered me. And now I can tell you how reefer, I didn't see it long as I was doing it. I can tell you how reefer will mess with your head, with your body. It'll destroy your body. I can tell you how alcohol can give you cirrhosis of the liver. Lord have mercy. I can tell you the different things, amen, that will happen to you in a world of sin because I was out there. I can tell you that when you're out there fornicating, that you're destroying your own body. That's God's word. God said a fornicator is destroying their own body. You're not destroying my body. You're destroying your own. People out here getting syphilis, getting AIDS, and getting all this from fornicating. They're picking up all these diseases, staph disease and all this. Unclean spirits. Unclean spirits bring about unclean spirits. But you got to live right. You got to walk upright. Hallelujah. If you find, amen, that you have to have a companion, get married. Do it right. Don't fornicate. What you look like laying up with a man or a woman for years and years and they never want to marry you? I've seen someone that have lived with someone for 20 years, had laid up and fornicated, shacked up with this person for 20 years and wind up marrying someone else. I know this. I know this for a fact because I know the people that did it. I know them. So because you laying up and shacking up with someone now, that doesn't mean that they're going to marry you. Because I've seen it done. You got to come out of your sin. Do it right with God. Songwriter say, get right with God. We got to get right with him and we got to do it now. We got to let God move for us. We got to let God deliver us. We got to let God bring us out. Hallelujah. Except God do it, it won't be done. It can't be done.
Right.
Hallelujah. The devil will pull you in and he'll hold you in long enough until he gets you. And then once he gets you, he'll start laughing at you and say, ha, 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 I got you now. And then he'll change on you. But one thing about God, God don't change. God is the same today, yesterday, and forevermore. God will never change on you. God will stay the same. God will continue to take care of you. He'll continue to bring you out. He'll continue to heal your body. He'll continue to put monies in your pockets. But you got to continue to serve God. You got to continue to trust God. Believe God. And God will. He'll bring you out. Read this last verse for us, this fourth verse.
For the Lord your God is he that goeth with you to fight for you against your enemies to save you.
God wants to save you. God wants to bring you out. He wants to deliver you. So he makes a way for you and he fights your enemies. God fights your enemies and he brings you out more than a conqueror. Look, when the enemy comes in like a flood, God will allow his spirit to lift you up. When the enemy come in one way, God will cause them to flee seven different ways. My God, my God. Our weapons are not carnal, but they're mighty through the pulling down. Pray, church, pray, pray. It's praying time. Hold one another up. Seek God for one another. If you see the enemy coming up against one of your loved ones, one of your friends, even your enemy, pray for him. Seek God for him. Trust God for him. Hallelujah. And God will bring you out every time. God will make a way for you. God will deliver you. Just trust him. Just trust God. Hallelujah. I know what God will do for you. I believe God. I believe God. I believe God. He's gonna do what he said. Trust and obey. There's no other way. I believe God. I believe God. I believe God. I believe God. He's gonna do what he say. Trust and obey. There's no other way. Just want everyone to believe God on this morning and to trust God. Amen. God will bring you out. God will make a way for you. Amen. I'm led to say this to that one. Amen. You've been trying to believe God, but it seemed like nothing is happening for you. You said that I've been doing all that I know how. Hallelujah. To trust God, and it seems like everything is still going wrong for me. But I came to tell you to hold on. Help is on the way. God is getting ready to deliver. There's someone out there that needs a healing in their body. Someone that's listening on this morning. And God is going to touch your body. Hallelujah. Someone the doctors has given up. Don't worry. Don't you fret. Because God is a healer, and he will deliver you. Just keep trusting God. Keep believing him. Lord, have mercy. We're going to have prayer. Hallelujah. Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord, I thank you this morning. I thank you for those that have tuned in and has listened this morning to us, God. And we're coming to thee, Lord, just as meek and humble as we know how. Thanking and praising you, Lord God, for this day. And asking you, Father God, to forgive us, Lord God, of our every sin and our every shortcoming. To blot out our transgressions and to purge us of our iniquities. Wash us, Lord God, whiter than snow. Lord God, create in us a clean heart and renew within us a right spirit. God, we thank you for this day. We thank you for your many blessings. God, we ask in you, Lord God, to look on the people out there in social media today, Lord God. You know what they stand in need of, Lord, and you know what they're asking you for, God. And I ask you, Lord God, to move in a special way. God, send your healing virtue, Lord God, to those that need a healing. Touch right now, God. Touch their bodies. Oh, God, in the name of Jesus. God, those that are going through financially, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, God, bless their finances. Move in their finances. God, give them overflow. God, you said if we give, it will be given unto us. Good measures, pressed down, shaken together, and running over, Lord, shall men give unto our bosom. Lord God, in the name of Jesus. Father God, I ask you to give. Cause man to give unto us. Lord God, we're standing on your word and on your promise. God, you said if we paid our tithes and gave offerings, Lord God, that you would open the windows of heaven and you would pour us out a blessing that we wouldn't have room enough to receive. Lord God, in the name of Jesus, that you would rebuke the devourer for our name's sake. God, move upon our enemies. Lord God, in the name of Jesus, and God, you bring us out. God, if you would save our enemies, Lord God, they would no longer be our enemies. Lord God, in the name of Jesus, continue to move, continue to deliver, continue to fight our battle. God, I know you're able. Lord God, I know that you can, and I know that you will. Lord God, in the mighty name of Jesus, God, go with my husband and the men. Yes. Lord God, you take care of them.
Yes, Jesus.
Lord God, work a special miracle. In the mighty name of Jesus, God, we thank you for this day. We thank you for your presence, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. God, we forever, Lord God, give your name, which is holy, to praise. In Jesus' name, amen. Those of you that's on social media, if you have a special prayer, amen, that you would love for us to pray for you, amen, while we're praying, amen, during this week, list it, put it, amen, put it on Facebook, put it in the comments, put it on Instagram, wherever you're listening to us through, put it on there, and we will be praying for you. We'll put your name, if you just say, put my name on the prayer list, we'll put your name on there, and we'll be praying for you every day. We'll be calling your name out in prayer. Amen. Whatever you stand in need of. At this time, we're asking everyone, amen, especially Holy Temple East. We thank God for those of Holy Temple East that's on here today. Amen. We want you, amen, to bless the house of prayer. Amen. Even though we're not in the church today, prayerfully we'll be back there next Sunday. Amen. In the house of prayer. And we're asking, amen, you to send a special offering. Amen. Those of you of Holy Temple East, you know what your special offering is today. Amen. And we're asking you to get your offering in. Amen. And don't forget to pay your tithes. Amen. And some of you, if you're listening in and you belong to another church, make sure your church get their tithes and offering. Amen. But if you don't, amen, belong somewhere else, we're asking you to support, amen, our ministry at Holy Temple Holiness Church of Deliverance East, located at 336 East 25th Street, amen, Baltimore, Maryland, 21218. Please support us, amen, and you can support us at $Holy Temple East. And we're going to put that in the comment so that you can see it. If you want to send Cash App, or you can send PayPal, and PayPal is the @ Holy Temple East. The @ Holy Temple East. And you can also Apple Pay at 410-258-5594. You can Apple Pay 410-258-5594. And if you desire to do the square, you can call in at that same number, 410-258-5594. So if you desire to be a blessing to this ministry, you can Cash App, you can PayPal, and you can Apple Pay. Amen. And we thank you all for tuning in today. I thank my daughter, Evangelist Bell, Evangelist Shelley, and my granddaughter. I thank God for her. Amen. Being here with us, Amaya Shelley, being with us here on the broadcast on this morning. And we pray, amen, that the word has reached someone on this morning, and you continue to pray for us, pray for our ministry. Amen. In Jesus' name, Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we thank you for the service on today, and we ask you, Lord God, to continue to go with us, watch over us and protect us, and keep us covered in your blood until we meet again. Amen and amen. Those of you that desire to see this broadcast again, you can tune in on Holy Temple East or YouTube, Overseer Pastor Shelley. That's Holy Temple East or
YouTube is Holy Temple Holiness Church of Deliverance East. So YouTube is the Holy Temple Holiness Church of Deliverance East, or on Instagram at the @ at Holy Temple East Baltimore.
Amen. So please join us. Amen, amen. God bless you, everyone.